In this problem, we are given that a solid cylinder of radius r has certain rotation about its axis with an angular speed omega naught and lowered with its lateral surface onto a horizontal plane and released. The friction coefficient between the cylinder and plane is mu, and we are required to find the time after which cylinder will start pure rolling. Let's first analyze and draw the situation. Here it is saying that on a rough ground where friction coefficient is mu, a cylinder is first set into rotation at an angular speed omega naught and is lowered onto the ground. When we place it on ground, due to its rotation, at the bottommost point it will experience a friction in forward direction, because all points at the bottom of the cylinder will be translating in backward direction. So as soon as these points will come in contact with the ground, these will experience a friction in forward direction, and obviously ground will experience friction in backward direction. And due to this friction, we can see the speed, linear speed of the cylinder will increase, and as the torque of this friction is opposite to this angular speed will decrease to omega. And say, if it is lowered at t equals to 0, we talk about the situation after time t, and after time t, say its speed is vf and its angular speed is omega f, and say it starts pure rolling. And for the case of pure rolling, we can write vf is equals to r omega f. Now in this situation, we are required to find the time after which it will start pure rolling. So here we write impulse equations. As already in the basic theory we have studied, such problems of rolling with a sliding can be easily handled by impulse equations. So as the friction coefficient is mu, we can write the friction to be equals to mu mg, as normal reaction acting on cylinder is equal to its weight. So here, due to this mu mg which is acting on it for a time t, the body has attained a speed vf. So we can write for translational motion, its initial momentum was 0 plus the impulse imparted by the friction will be mu mg t is equals to the final impulses mvf. This is our first equation. For rotational motion, if we just have a look, the initial angular momentum of the cylinder we can write as half mr square into omega naught, which was the initial angular speed. And as the torque of friction is opposing, we can write it minus mu mg rt, as the torque due to this friction is mu mg r into the time, which is equal to the final angular momentum, which can be written as half mr square into the final angular speed omega, which can be written as vf by r, as pure rolling will start after time t, which is our equation number 2. And here this mass gets cancelled out, here also mass gets cancelled out. If we add the two equations, this mu mg t will also cancel out, as we can also cancel this radius. In this situation, the result will be getting on left hand side is half r omega naught, and on right hand side of equality will be getting vf plus vf by 2, it is 3 by 2 vf. From here, we'll get the final linear speed when the cylinder will start pure rolling is equals to 1 by 3 r omega naught. And as we are required to find the time after which it will start pure rolling, then we can use it from equation 1. So we can write from equation 1, we are having t is equals to v final by mu g. So we just substitute the value of v final, it is r omega naught by 3 mu g, that will be the answer to our problem.